guys, welcome back to the channel. It is Sunday and it has been raining all day, guys, and I was getting into a slump. Like, I'm telling you, it was like Netflix, napping, it was bad. So I'm like, I need to film. So today we are going to do a Mally Cosmetics review, and I've been accumulating these products for a few months. I'm so excited to finally review them with you guys. Before we get on to the review, if you guys could give this video a thumbs up and subscribe down below, that'd mean a lot to me. Okay guys, so I'm going to give a 30-second introduction to Mally Cosmetics before we go ahead and apply these products. So this line was created by Mally Roncal, I believe that's how you pronounce it. She is an on-the-go makeup artist. She does makeup for some of the big celebrity names out there. I think she's done for Angelina Jolie, so that is awesome. But she actually decided to create her own line of makeup. She started this 9 years ago. Excuse me while I look at my notes. Okay, so she calls her beauty bulletproof. So basically she is creating these glamorous looks for celebrities, and she wanted to be able to bring that to the average ordinary woman without it being too expensive, which I think it is kind of expensive personally. But apparently, you know, it's supposed to be smudge proof and stay put, and you get that glamorous look without having to hire your own makeup artist. Okay guys, so that is that. Let's get on to applying this face. Okay guys, so we're starting out this tutorial with nothing on the face because I actually got a lot of the Mally Cosmetics like face products. So yeah, nothing on my face right now. I am breaking out pretty bad, like right around like my lip area, my chin, along my jawline. I do think that is stress induced, but I'll save that for a vlog. Let's get on with the makeup. The first product we'll be using is the Mally Perfect Prep Neutralizing Primer. So guys, a lot of the Mally makeup products have silicone in them. That's the primary ingredient that Mally uses in all of her makeup. And while this like completely covers everything, covers all your blemishes, and it's smudge proof, you also have the issues that it also traps in like skin debris and really keeps your skin clogged. The silicone acts as a barrier so that, you know, nothing can escape from your face. That also includes moisture. So your skin does stay moisturized with this line of makeup. I have an oily skin-based tone, and I would really recommend, I think this line of makeup would be awesome for someone with dry skin because it's trapping in the moisture and it's retaining any oils from your face. But if you have a dry skin, that's not a big issue for you. For me, it is an issue. So this line that I'm going to go through, I decided that like I only wear it for like a few hours at a time. I won't wear it like all day at work. All of Mally's products does have a pump at the top, which is like really convenient. I love makeup that has this. So I'm basically just going to dot this all over the face, rub in. Yeah, if you guys are looking for some type of line of makeup that is like perfecting and you have dry skin, this is definitely the line for you. Even if you have oily skin and you want something just to wear for like a few hours, like a wedding or something, and you want your skin to look really nice, I might still recommend the Mally line. So I can tell just right now looking at it and from previous wear that it really does smooth the surface of my skin, fills in the pores, and has like a nice base for the foundation. Also, I wanted to add that this runs for $35 and has a 4.5 rating on Google. The next thing we're going to use from Mally is the H3 Concealer. It looks like this. Now, this little thing costs $27 but has a 4.4 star rating. Everything in the Mally line is pretty expensive. That's why I've been waiting to do the full Mally review, because I've been getting a few products each month, kind of like building up so I can do a full review for you guys. And I will say one thing that is surprising is silicone is one of the number one ingredients that makeup brands use in their cosmetics, and that is because it is a cheaper ingredient. So for the prices to be that steep on this makeup line is a little, I feel like they should be a little lower. So the packaging from the concealer says, need an instant refresher for eyes? Mally's got you covered with her Silky H3 Concealer, formulated to deliver intense boosting hydration. The creamy, long-wearing formula gives skin instant radiance, blurring imperfections, softening the look of fine lines. So yeah, it won't budge, it is long wearing, but at the same time, you will be breaking out if you have oily skin, you're wearing this for a very long amount of time. I'm gonna use more concealer than I normally do with you guys, just because I have so many blemishes right now. I always do like to cover right here where I have some scarring. I use so much product. in this area. That's probably why I go through my concealer so freaking fast. Okay, I'm just going to take my beauty blender and blend that out. I'm telling you guys, if I had dry skin, I would love this line so much. Because I do feel like it looks so nice, but it just worries me that I'm going to break out even more than I have been lately. Okay, so next is the foundation. This is called the Complexion Perfection Soft Focus Foundation. I did take some notes, guys, as you can tell, because I definitely want these to be informative and not just your ordinary YouTube video. I want you guys to be very informed before you make a purchase, especially when they're as expensive as the Maui line. So this foundation does run for $38, but it actually has a 5-star rating on Google, which is like really impressive because you don't see that very often. Again, number one ingredient is silicone. It's a very moisturizing version of silicone that you'll find in a lot of hair products. And we have another nice little pump here. I'm just gonna pump a little bit on my beauty blender and blend away. This does have a strong smell to it. To me, it smells like it would be silicone. And I will say too, like, I have tested this wearing it to work to see how it lasts. And after like a long day of work, I will say, like, I can tell I'm wearing a silicone-based foundation because it just feels like very heavy and thick, like on my face. Like those days, I can't wait to get home just to wash my face off. Can see the difference between like my cheeks, my forehead. Like, it is so skin perfecting. It's wild. And guys, I will zoom you in here. I just want you to see the difference between the foundation on my face and without any foundation. So you can see it really is perfecting. Actually, it's crazy to see in the mirror and in the camera right now. Like, I've worn this a lot, but just to see it again, I don't know, it still surprises me every time, like how flawless it makes your skin look. I will say, even though it's perfecting, you can definitely look at my face and be like, okay, that girl has like makeup on, you know what I mean? It's not that like no makeup makeup look. And I will go ahead and read off what the packaging says for this foundation. The search for flawless skin is over. This lightweight, that's a lie, oil-free liquid foundation delivers medium to full coverage for a seriously smooth, natural-looking complexion. Skin looks even, balanced, and flawlessly fierce. That's all the face products I had from Maui. So basically what I'm going to do right now is go into my contour, highlighting, and blush. And basically I'll show you the products that I'm using, but I'm not going to talk. I'm just going to fast forward through it so we can get to the eyes, which I do have two Maui items to use for the eyes I want to show you guys. Okay, I lied. One thing. I did notice whenever I put some powder foundation over top of the liquid, it does mattify it and it gives it a little more of a natural look. Moving on. Thank you. eyes, so we are ready for the eyes.
So the two products we'll be using is the Mally Nude Attitude and the Ever Shadow Stick.
So I wasn't actually planning on getting this until I saw it on the 21 Days of Beauty, so I snatched it up to do with the review. But I've actually had my eyes on this guy for a little while now because the colors look amazing. So let me show you these. So you can tell with the sand shade I went in with a wet brush. Look at that. This is pretty bad. I forgot to mention that all of our face products that we use were made in the United States. However, this eyeshadow palette by Mally is made in China. So that was like kind of strange to me that everything was produced in the United States except for this eyeshadow palette. It is only priced at $35, which I think is actually decent considering the prices for some other palettes out there. But I was definitely bummed it was made in China because I just feel like whenever you order something from China, the quality just isn't as good as a product made in the United States. However, this did have a 4.4 rating on Google, so most people are enjoying this palette. I feel like this palette offers a lot of different looks between like cool and warm going on here. You have like this icy blue, some silverish gold here, but then you have like these dark warm colors here. So there are two shades in here, the Claret and Quartz, that are a satin finish. What that means basically is it's a nice like medium mix between like a matte and like a shimmer shade, like somewhere right in the middle. And then Cocoa, Cafe Au Lait, Sand, Russet, and Slate, they are a pearl formula, which is a buttery, subtle metallic. And then we also have our matte shades, the Tawny, Chestnut, Cream, and Carbon. And then we have a metallic shade, the Terra Rosa, in the top left. So something cool about this palette with the 12 shades in it is that you can split it up into three different quads. What's cool about that is each quad is kind of like its own look. I'll show you the back of the packaging, what I mean by that. And also I did forget to mention that this palette is exclusive to Ulta only. Okay guys, so before we get into this eyeshadow look, let me tell you what I've been thinking about the formula. Number one, I will say you can come up with some beautiful looks with this palette. Number two, a lot of the shades in here, well not a lot, but maybe like a third or a fourth of the shades in there are more of like a frost formula because they're just not pigmented enough. But that can actually work for you in the look you're creating. Like the quartz is more like a frost look, and if I put it over a shadow, it creates this really pretty glisteny look. So that's okay with me. The only downside of this palette, which goes against like everything that Mally preaches about everything being like bulletproof and smudge proof, is I just feel like these shadows don't hold up throughout the day. And I feel bad saying that, like I think Mally Cosmetics has a great line of makeup, but just with this palette, and I don't know if it is because of that feature, you know, like that it's made in China, but if I put this beautiful look together and I'm like, oh my gosh, I love this palette. But by the end of the day, it honestly has almost like smudged into one giant like color, if that makes sense. So I'm just going to give that warning before we make this look because I know this look is going to probably look really nice. And you guys may want to get this palette after I come up with a look, but I just want to let you know that, you know, it may not hold up for a very long amount of time. So anyways guys, let's just get started on this look and see what we come up with. I am going to go ahead and zoom you guys in so you can see a close up of how this look comes together. And that tawny shade I showed you is seriously one of my favorite transition shades like out of any palette. So I do love that about this palette. It probably is my favorite shade in the palette altogether. So I am going to come up with a look that I haven't actually done yet, so hopefully this comes out looking okay. But a shade I haven't got to use yet is this Slate shade right here. And I was kind of scared too because I feel like blues can come out looking really tacky on the eyes. But after I swatched this again for you guys, I realized it's more of like a grayish blue. So I think actually that we can work with this. So I'm just going to work that in the crease. So are you guys seeing this? Like, I feel like this is what I'm talking about. The color is like kind of smudged together, it seems like. I don't know. And I feel like the formula is pretty dry as well, and I think that is what does not keep it from staying in the same spot. So I feel like this is turning out kind of messy right now.
And it looks like I got punched in the eye. Great. So I feel like that slate shade that I hadn't actually tried out before, like I put a little bit on the brush and when I went to move it around, it just poof everywhere. Let's see if we can fix this up. I think I'm gonna take this black carbon shade and do the outer corner to darken it up some. I'm gonna use a more precise brush on this to make sure we keep it exactly where we want it. Okay, so I think that helped things along somewhat. Before I get too lost in this look, I want to take this Ever Color Shadow Stick and put it in the inner corner. Now, I will say that this definitely is smudge proof. I've swatched it before and like I literally could not get it off my hand, so that tells me it's going to stay in place. This product as well was made in China. It retails for $25 and it has a 4.5 star rating on Google. So this is really pretty. I think I'm gonna work it like at least halfway through my lid. Actually, I wanna work it towards the black. Okay, that looks really nice. Okay, I'm liking this. It's coming along, thank goodness, I was worried. So I am gonna take this fluffy brush and go back in with that carbon and blend it a little bit into that shadow stick. I think lastly to finish this look off, I'm going to go in with this quartz shade. It is a pretty frosty type shade, so I'm not sure if it'll show up or not, but I want to try and use as much product as possible to show you guys kind of how it looks. Okay, so yeah, I'm definitely seeing that. Are you guys? Then I think for the lower lid, I'm going to go in with some of the carbon. And we'll be finishing off this look with a ColourPop shade called Flitter. Okay guys, so this is the look we came up with together. I'm definitely satisfied, happy with Mally's Cosmetics. It's not perfect, it definitely has like its issues, but for the most part, like I'm looking at my face, I think it looks really nice. I wouldn't wear this product all day because I know it is bad for trapping oil and skin debris, but I love the way it looks, so I guess that's something. Okay guys, so the results are in, let's check these ratings. And don't forget guys, these are rated on my personal feelings, and you know, I have oily skin, you know, this would probably be completely different if you had dry skin. So the primer gets a 6. Concealer, we will do a 7. Foundation, we're gonna go with an 8, it just keeps going up. The Mally Nude Attitude Eyeshadow Palette, we're gonna go with a 5. Yeah, just kidding, that's going down. And the eyeshadow stick, I'm gonna go with a 10 because I think it looks gorgeous and it stays put all day. Alright guys, so that concludes our Mally Cosmetics review. I hope you enjoyed this and didn't put you to sleep. I tried to be kind of informative so you guys were learning something and I wasn't just throwing the products on my face. Anyways guys, thank you so much for tuning in. I'll catch you on my next video. See ya!